And hello, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna be trying something new. By the title you can tell that it sounds a little crazy, but if you do some research about it, it's actually not, it makes sense. I'm going to be putting beer in my hair. So I watched this video which was kind of mind-blowing, and it said beer in your hair, and I was like, okay, interesting. And I will link the video down below because it's going to be more informative than mine, but mine is just more of an experiment.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
I'm just trying it out for myself to see if my hair will like it, and that's basically it. So what you use beer for? You use beer if you have dry hair and a dry scalp. So beer basically contains ingredients like malt and hops, which is protein, and we all know that our hair is made out of protein, therefore it needs protein in order to thrive. Beer has vitamin B, minerals, and amino acids. I'm not saying that if you drink beer you're gonna have really good hair, because that's a different story. At the end of the day, beer is alcohol, and alcohol is not good for your hair. But the way that she makes this is that you don't actually use it as a rinse. I thought I was gonna have to use it as a rinse in my hair, like how you use an apple cider vinegar rinse, a rice water rinse, you know, all of those are like rinses. But then she makes it a mask. How she created that mask was she boiled the beer, which is exactly what I'm gonna do, and she boiled it for 10 minutes, and then which allows the alcohol to, I think, evaporate or something. What the fuck, it's not supposed to be doing this. Oh shit, I'm in trouble. Okay, it's gonna pop, it's coming out. Oh, here we go. I stirred it a little bit and now it's back to normal. And then she added 2 eggs. She used egg yolk. She also mentioned that you can use any kind of beer. I mean, they almost all have relatively the same ingredients. So I'm using the Black Label beer. Yeah, that one. And it's the ingredients you can see here. It's barley malt, maize extract. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I am so used to reading ingredients of hair products, and the fact that I'm reading ingredients off of beer as it, because this is now like officially a hair product. If it works, it's going to be a hair product. That means I'll be putting beer in my hair, and these are the ingredients: malt and hops. It says maize extract and hops, I don't know what that is. It's in there, and those are proteins. The reason why you use it once to twice a month is because of the high protein content that it has. You don't want your hair to have too much protein, because I think it can also like dry out your hair a little bit. So too much of a good thing is bad, especially when it's beer. You know, you don't want to have beer in your hair all the time. I feel like it'll start to smell like it. That's why I'm happy that you can use it once to twice a month. And I'll also be making the whole mask with the egg yolk. So I've never put eggs in my hair before. I've done it for my friend, and I've seen many tutorials about it. Some argue that the protein content in eggs is just too big to penetrate your hair shaft and all that stuff, and so I never really bothered myself to try eggs, the whole eggs and mayonnaise treatment. I just have a fear of putting eggs because it can cook in your hair. And when I did it on my friend's hair, I remember I washed her hair with lukewarm water, and it did cook, and it took time to get some of that egg out. I'm not even, but it was mostly the white parts that were like that visible and cooked. soap, but I'm only using the egg yolk, so maybe it's not going to have that effect on me. I will give you the tea on this beer tomorrow morning, and so you are gonna get my full honest review on this product right here. And yeah, by the way, I am not sponsored. Okay, I have my mixture with me and my shampoo. I'm using the Native Child Moisturizing Shampoo, and I'm going to wash my hair and then apply this. It's very liquid, so I'm kind of interested to see how it's gonna feel on my hair. Finally done with this. I don't even know what to call it. It was just a lot. And I'll see you guys in the morning. I'm back with the results and I have a few things to say. Number one, it's very messy. I smelled like alcohol. It's very watery, so the mask or treatment just kept running down my face because of the eggs inside, so my skin felt sticky. And the smell in the bathroom lasted a really long time. Like, imagine mixing beer and eggs together, just imagine the smell. The only time I'll be doing this would be if I ran out of conditioner and deep conditioner and I had beer and eggs. I would do that because I didn't need to use a conditioner after the treatment. And that's it, guys. That's all I have to say, and I'll see you next week. Bye.